It seemed like you were living in that Melrose Mindoro backfield. Defensively, how fired up was the unit today?
We were really fired up. We came out, you know, first game for the playoffs, and we wanted to play Cuba City. You know, we heard they won, and we wanted to get another chance at them and come back out with another big win.
I think I had Melrose Mindoro for 6 total yards in the first half. That's a pretty good day's defensive work. What did you see there that you felt you could dominate, and how proud of you were you of the performance, especially in the first half?
Well, we came out with a 3-front, and we stopped the runs with a 3-front, and so we knew they'd have to pass the ball, and we just did a good job. Our tackles and DNs keeping them inside. They got some pretty quick guys in the backfield, so we did pretty good there.
Their coach talked about the difference in size, and you know, we saw that up here. Fans that were here today saw that. I know this is an exceptionally big Darlington team, but you're not just you know, slow big guys. You fly to the football too. Is that what you pride yourself on?
Yeah, everybody just gets around the football. You know, coaches saying in film, all those black jerseys or white jerseys around the ball. You know, and when somebody hits the ball out and we get a fumble recovery, that's always nice too.
You pitch a shutout today, and again, you know, a lot of talk already about next week in Cuba City, and they did put 14 on you at the first meeting, and you know, made it quite a ball game. What's defensively, as you look ahead, what's the challenge this week, preparation for the Cubans?
Stopping Preston Dressler. He's a good quarterback, and we just got to keep him contained and just go at him.
You looking forward to that, I bet, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Definitely. Well, Riley Ray, congratulations.